This weekend marks the 54th anniversary of the Bay of Pigs, when an army of Cuban exiles recruited by the CIA, largely in Miami, invaded Cuba with the intention of toppling the regime of Fidel Castro. What most Americans remember about that is that it ended disastrously, and that Fidel Castro remained in power, the Castro regime remained in power for another 50 years. What most people don't know is that several American newspapers, knew about the invasion in advance and didn't say anything. One of those papers was the Miami Herald. It all started when a teenager in Homestead threw some firecrackers over a fence at what he thought were migrant workers as a kind of a joke. They shot back, he was wounded in the head, and the police were called. When the police wouldn't say what happened, the Miami Herald became suspicious.
Well, the story was about a plan by the CIA to recruit and train Cuban exiles for some sort of military operation against the Castro regime. We had no idea what the details of that operation were going to be, but we knew that this activity was going on in Miami. Well, the story never saw the daylight because the decision was made after consultation with the director of the CIA, Alan Dulles. The decision was made by Herald Management that they were afraid that publishing the story might do some harm to national security, as Dulles advised us. And whether or not publication of the story would have prevented the Bay of Pigs from ever happening, one never knows. But it might have made it more difficult.